Bonjour à tous. Hello, everyone. I want to start today with news about changes to our Liberal cabinet team. This morning, Navdeep Bains announced that he'll be stepping down as Minister of Innovation, Science and Industry to spend more time with his family. He will continue to serve as Member of Parliament for Mississauga-Malton and will, of course, remain a key member of our Liberal team. Over the past 5 years, Nav has worked tirelessly to build a better Canada for everyone. Look no further than the program he worked on this spring to help businesses retool to make life-saving personal protective equipment. Before the pandemic, Canada produced about 1% of the domestic PPE we used. By the fall, almost half of the PPE Canada was buying was from domestic companies. Nav's work helped create thousands of jobs and support promising small businesses. He led the way with investments in cutting-edge Canadian science and in local economic growth with the innovation superclusters. He did all this while being a strong advocate for his community. So a few days ago, Nav called me up to ask to go for a walk in the snow. And I think we all know what that means in politics, so I was a little trepidatious about it, and I was busy coming up with all sorts of arguments as to why we should continue to work together the way we have been. And as we walked around the grounds of Rideau Hall, physically distanced with masks on, it became very clear that this was the right decision for him, for his family. He's been in this a long time. He was already well into politics when I got my start way back in 2006, 2007, and was a great friend to me throughout the entire time. He's continuing as MP. He's not going anywhere. But we will miss him around the cabinet table for all the insight, all the wisdom, and all the strength he brings. I also, of course, want to thank Bram, Nanki, and Kirpa for having shared him with us for all these years. His service has been extraordinary, and I know we're going to miss him, but you're going to miss him less, the three of you. Plus tôt aujourd'hui, nous avons procédé à quelques changements au sein du Conseil des ministres suite à l'annonce de Navdeep. Tout d'abord, c'est le ministre Champagne qui deviendra le nouveau ministre de l'Innovation, des Sciences et de l'Industrie. En tant que ministre des Affaires étrangères lors d'une crise mondiale sans précédent, le leadership de François Philippe a été essentiel quand le temps est venu du plus grand effort de rapatriement de citoyens canadiens de notre histoire ou de sécuriser les chaînes d'approvisionnement. La dernière année a représenté un défi sans précédent à tant d'égards et le ministre Champagne a défendu haut et fort les intérêts du Canada sur la scène internationale. Grâce à son travail, on a pu renforcer nos alliances avec d'autres pays au sein d'institutions internationales telles que la francophonie. Son expérience dans le domaine des affaires, incluant le secteur de l'innovation, est un atout important alors qu'on rebâtit une économie plus inclusive et plus résiliente. En tant que député représentant une circonscription rurale, je sais que François Philippe continuera de porter la voix des régions, y compris dans ce nouveau dossier très important. À partir d'aujourd'hui, le ministre Garneau servira en tant que ministre des Affaires étrangères. Que ce soit ici sur Terre ou à partir de l'espace, Marc a toujours su représenter le Canada. Son expérience récente en travaillant avec la communauté internationale suite à la tragédie du vol 752 va certainement lui servir grandement dans le cadre de ce nouveau poste. As Minister of Transport, Minister Garneau moved the dial on a range of important issues, including the Safer Skies Initiative and the Oceans Protection Plan. These files and others will be in very good hands as Omar Al-Khabra takes over as Minister of Transport. I've known Omar for a very long time, from my very beginnings in politics. And from his recent work as Parliamentary Secretary to the Prime Minister, I know he'll do an outstanding job. Minister Al-Khabra brings to the table training as an engineer and in business, a history of advocacy for public transit in the GTA, and experience with everything from NGOs to the energy sector. This is in addition to his leadership on files like public service renewal and diversity. Finally, today we also announced that Minister Carr will be rejoining the Cabinet table in his role as my special representative for the Prairies. While he's been focusing on his health over the past many months, Jim has remained a very active voice for Winnipeg, for Manitoba, and for the Prairies. Having served as both Minister of Natural Resources and Minister of International Trade Diversification, as well as being a business leader in Winnipeg, Jim knows what communities and businesses need to succeed. He will continue to be an outstanding advocate for people across the Prairies as a member of Cabinet once again. Right from day one, it's been all hands on deck to keep people safe, support Canadians, and get our economy ready for a recovery. Starting today, I will be holding a virtual Cabinet retreat so that our team can meet and map out our plan to continue this work. At the top of the agenda will be the vaccine rollout. And on that front, today I have some important news to share. I can announce that we have reached an agreement with Pfizer to buy an additional 20 million doses of their COVID-19 vaccine. From our agreements with Moderna and Pfizer alone, we will now have 80 million doses of COVID-19 vaccines arriving this year. We're on track to have every Canadian who wants a vaccine receive one by September. We've let all provinces and territories know exactly how many vaccines they'll be receiving every week between now and the end of February. This will make sure that they have the vaccines and the information they need to keep rolling out doses as quickly, as smoothly, and as efficiently as possible. On top of that, we will of course continue to work to get even more vaccines delivered as soon as we can. Aujourd'hui, je peux aussi annoncer que nous avons conclu une entente avec Pfizer pour accélérer la livraison des doses de leur vaccin. D'ici la mi-printemps, entre avril et juin, nous aurons assez de doses pour vacciner jusqu'à 20 millions de personnes. Avec cette nouvelle, on se rapproche encore plus de notre objectif, qui est d'offrir des vaccins à tous les Canadiens d'ici l'automne. Le Major Général Fortin et le Dr New en auront plus à dire sur ce sujet dans leur point de presse ce jeudi. Déjà, des gens vulnérables et des travailleurs de première ligne ont reçu des doses qui leur sont vitales. Notre gouvernement va continuer de travailler sans relâche avec les provinces et les territoires pour que les vaccins soient livrés et les gens soient immunisés aussi vite et efficacement que possible. En ce moment, c'est notre priorité. Pendant que notre gouvernement fait ce qu'il faut pour vous aider, vous et vos proches, à traverser la pandémie, on pense aussi à la suite des choses. La relance doit être profitable pour tous les Canadiens. C'est pour cette raison qu'on a un plan pour bâtir un pays plus fort et plus résilient où tout le monde aura la chance de réussir. En plus d'investir dans la formation des travailleurs ou de créer des millions d'emplois, on sait qu'une véritable action climatique doit être à la base de notre démarche. Hier, j'ai participé au sommet One Planet, qui réunissait des dirigeants d'ailleurs dans le monde pour faire avancer la lutte contre les changements climatiques et la protection de la biodiversité. Le Canada est à la tête des efforts réalisés à l'échelle internationale pour soutenir des projets de gestion durable des terres dans le monde entier. Et nous le faisons tout en poursuivant nos efforts réalisés ici, au pays, pour protéger la nature et garder les communautés en santé. Notre gouvernement continuera d'investir pour que le monde d'aujourd'hui et de demain soit meilleur, en bonne santé et plus prospère. Our focus since the start of this pandemic has been protecting you and your family, whether by procuring vaccines or by bringing in strict travel and border measures. Our priority is your safety. This morning, I can confirm that Canada will extend by another 30 days until February 21st, the border measures that are currently in place with the United States. This is an important decision and one that will keep people on both sides of the border safe. Things are really tough right now, and we all want this pandemic to be behind us. There have been a lot of things you've missed out on, or given up. But what will define this pandemic isn't what we couldn't do. It's what we could do and what we did do. Your parents and grandparents need you to help keep them safe. Our frontline workers and hospital staff need you to do your part so ICUs don't get overwhelmed. Even small actions can make a huge difference, like wearing a mask or downloading and using COVID Alert. Canada has now hit over 6 million downloads of the app. That's great, so let's keep going. Of course, not everything you can do to help will be easy. It won't be easy when you say no to a friend who wants to get together, or when you cancel a vacation south, but it'll be worth it. On peut tous faire des choix pour protéger les gens autour de nous. On peut tous faire notre part d'effort pour traverser la pandémie. Je pense à toutes les personnes au Québec qui respectent le couvre-feu que la province a instauré. Je sais que ça amène des sacrifices. Quand vous faites votre part, vous protégez votre famille et vous êtes solidaire des travailleurs de première ligne. Pour faire face à l'augmentation du nombre de cas, plusieurs provinces auront à prendre encore des décisions difficiles, que ce soit en imposant des restrictions locales ou un confinement à la grandeur de la province. Notre gouvernement est là pour soutenir le Québec et tous les gouvernements qui prennent des décisions difficiles, mais nécessaires, pour assurer la sécurité des gens. On continue aussi d'envoyer du matériel essentiel, comme de l'équipement de protection individuelle et des trousses de dépistage aux provinces et aux territoires. Il est crucial que ces tests soient utilisés partout au pays lorsque c'est nécessaire, que ce soit dans les écoles ou dans les centres de soins de longue durée. Pour arrêter la propagation de la COVID-19, plus de gens doivent pouvoir passer des tests rapides. As we deal with the second wave, our government will continue to support the provinces and territories with rapid tests and other tools needed to keep Canadians safe. Already, we've sent over 14 million rapid test kits to the provinces and territories, with more on the way. It's by working together that we will get through this crisis. This is the time to have each other's backs and to support the leadership communities need. Today, I can announce the appointment of Eva Ariak as the new Commissioner of Nunavut. Mrs. Ariak has been a lifelong champion for the territory as well as for Inuit languages and culture. As Nunavut's first woman premier, and as an advocate for everything from housing to food security, I know Ms. Ariak will continue doing great work in this new role. This pandemic is a challenge like no other. Now, more than ever, we need to be there for each other. A little while ago, Najma and Kareem from Toronto sent me a letter about what the last year had been like for them as small business owners and as parents. Things have been tough, but they talked about how the wage subsidy helped keep their business open and how the Canada Child Benefit made a huge difference for their family. Well, on Friday, I gave them a call to see how things were going. They're staying positive, but our conversation reminded me that when we look out for the people around us, there's no challenge we cannot overcome. This will be a tough winter, but it will end. Spring will come, and summer will follow. But until then, let's have each other's backs, because together we can get through this. Merci.